What's going on, everybody? We got some Bleach news, so let's talk about it, shall we? But of course, we got to talk about where it all started. Now, of course, we're going to do this as what we know at the moment already, and then we're going to be talking about future stuff that hasn't been officially announced. So bear with me if you've already heard the news already. So let's talk about where it all started off. On the 20th of January, your boy James actually made a tweet. So if you don't follow me, go follow me on at James Hansen. I made a tweet saying Burn the Witch anime OVA for spring 2020. Of course, this naturally got a lot of backlash and a lot of people coming at my neck, which is understandable, for me to only then tweet out a few days later saying that the Burn the Witch news that I had dropped was only icing on the cake, essentially, and you will hear something more in the future. A few days after that, we actually had an official announcement. Not of the OVA anime, but instead of Bleach's 20th anniversary project and Taikubo's new work at Anime Japan 2020. If you guys don't know what Anime Japan is, it kind of says in the name, they announce animes. So there you go. There you go. So as well as that, we had a PV that I assume showed on TV, So here you go, check that out right here.
Bleach 20-year project and Kubo Taito 新作発表会.
So as well as that, we also got a new Bleach website. Unfortunately, this is a website that can't be data mined because it's not a singular domain. It actually shares the domain of Shonen Jump magazine. So it's not a singularity here, which is unfortunate, but really exciting nonetheless. And we have the Bleach logo, kind of the Bleach logo, and it says Face Again. Now, of course, I've seen many people speculate what Face Again means. There is a chapter in Bleach called Face Again, which is very early on in Bleach. I guess maybe it has a hint in that chapter, I don't know. There's also people saying, oh, well, the ending of Bleach, ending 30 of the anime, Ichigo's got no face. But that was more of an artistical thing because, like, he was depressed and, like, Orihime and everyone gave him, like, a rainbow and it got rid of his dark side. It doesn't really matter. I think that's a bit of a reach, personally. I don't know what it means, if I'm completely honest with you. I have an idea, but I don't want to say anything to get people's hopes up here. So I'm going to leave that very ambiguous for now, and it will probably come full circle once it gets announced, right? So that's going to be happening for March 21st. To 2020. And the reason why I say those two dates in particular is because Anime Japan posted their schedule. And this is where it gets very important now. At this event at Anime Japan, there is going to be two voice actors, being Ichigo Kurosaki's voice actor and Byakuya Kuchiki's voice actor. There is also going to be Kubo at the event as well. And there's also going to be Nakano, who is the editor and editor at Weekly Shonen Magazine, or Weekly Shonen Jump Magazine, I should specify, with Aniplex hosting the event. Now, why is this all important? Well, this is all we know for now. And of course, people are going mental, they're going mad, they're going insane. Fantastic. I love the fact that everyone was going crazy. Now, here's where it gets important. This is why I have to emphasize on this in particular. Again, if you don't follow me on Twitter, I suggest you do so. I have known this for a very, very long time. I tweeted about, well, I didn't tweet about, but I just simply tweeted Aniplex, which I knew since September. So people in Reddit, because I know you're watching Reddit because you love me. You absolutely adore the shit out of me. Aniplex, you can't say that's coincidental. And if you can, fair enough, you probably will anyway. But yeah, I knew it was Aniplex, and I'll address that more later on. So the next question is like, okay, well, what's going to be announced at Anime Japan? And this is where it gets a little bit confusing, because Burn the Witch is confirmed. Like, it just really is at this point. Like, it's happening. There's a lot of plans for Burn the Witch, and a lot of the Western side of the industry knows about Burn the Witch. The problem here is that not many people know what's going on with the whole Bleach situation, because when the website came out, many of the industries were scratching their head because they didn't actually know why Bleach was being thrown into this mix. So, of course, we're going to get a Burn the Witch anime and all that sort of stuff, but as I said, and I have to specify really clearly here, is that it says Bleach's 20th anniversary project. So there's a project in ties with Bleach. And, which please understand the definition of and Taikubo's new works. Now, of course, we could have another Sakura Wars situation where they use the Bleach name to push something else. It is a possibility Shueisha have been known to do this. But, you know, I'm keeping my high spirits in regards to this. And I'll explain why, because it's because I know things, right? So, where do we start off first? Well, I guess we should start off with Aniplex. So, Aniplex has got the rights to Bleach. It had the rights to Bleach, I would say, around about August, maybe September of... or maybe even possibly earlier than that, or they were in the rights to, or interim of doing that. Aniplex own the rights to Bleach now. Now, of course, realistically, they could have just bought the rights to Burn the Witch and animated Burn the Witch and made their money off that. But no, they bought both IPs. And this is what I had been saying for quite a while, and I will roll the video since August, because I actually stated this in the first place. I stated that there was a new production committee being made, and you will see Bleach get removed off Netflix very, very soon. And it started with like Germany, France, and all those guys, and then quite recently hit the UK. Needs, in essence, a new production committee at the moment, and it's in that process to do so. I think if I said any more than that, I feel like it will be very detrimental to the process. I mean, recently I said on Twitter that Bleach would be starting to be removed off Netflix on the 24th of August, and it happened. And that's not actually a bad thing. Just let it do what it needs to do. You will probably see Bleach appear on things less and less and less. And that, again, and that includes Hulu and Netflix, all that jazz. It needs to happen. And anyone with a mindset will understand why it needs to happen. But that's kind of all I can say. But Bleach is still very much, it's still a very much profitable series. People still want it. Shueisha knows, they understand, I can say that much. Nakano again saying that to support Kubo and Bleach within the future. What would there to be supporting about Bleach if there was not going to be any more product to that? If somebody can come up with a legitimate argument for that, then please feel free to. So the question is, when will we see something in regards to the Bleach anime being announced? You will probably hear something. I'm not going to say this Jump Fest. The Jump Fest has been a bit of a meme. But I feel like they're definitely doing something for its anniversary. I can't comment on that because I don't know anything. But I feel like that is the plan moving forward. That's pretty much the update on the Bleach anime. It is coming back. It is. I don't know when. But it is. And that's all I can say. It's difficult because I will get criticized at the end of December or January when 2019 is over. It's going to get criticized. I'm definitely going to get criticized for saying X, Y, and Z because it did become a bit of a big video. And in retaliation to that, not retaliation, but as a defense to that, is go for it. Absolutely blast the fuck out of me. Unsubscribe right now if you don't trust or believe me or feel like I clickbaited you, because realistically I know what I know and I can't say anything, and I shouldn't have been as abrasive as I did. As time goes on, I'm learning more and more and more about the industry, and I'm learning more and more about what's happening, and I'm trying to prove that as much as I can on Twitter, proving every single criticism as much as I can wrong. But I've come to learn to the fact that people just don't want to believe in the things that you say. As of right now, Viz Europe do not own the license to Bleach at all. It is done. They do not own the license to Bleach. This is because, you know, Aniplex have bought the rights now, and we're just waiting for the licenses to expire for things to progress forward. Hence why we're getting Burn the Witch stuff, because it's to give something for the fans while we wait for that ultimate thing. And also for a long-term Jeopardy thing too, so we got loads of content to look forward to in the future. So, you know, whatever it is with Burn the Witch, it is very imperative, and I will keep saying this, it is very imperative that you support Burn the Witch. So, that's going to be exciting. So yes, as I said, Burn the Witch anime is happening, and Aniplex have bought the rights to Bleach and Burn the Witch. Which is very interesting, because I have to think of a way to say this, and it's very not-so-blunt ways of doing this. Because now people are going to ask, well, what's going to happen with Bleach, right? And again, we have to wait for licenses to expire until we actually fully know. But you have to think the amount of money a company has to pay for their, you know, like if I'm Aniplex, right, and I have to buy the rights off someone, I have to put in a lot of money to buy those rights, correct? So you're telling me they're just going to buy the rights to Bleach and not do anything with it? No, that'd be absolutely ludicrous. And anyone with any kind of business mindset knows that you don't need to buy Bleach's rights to do Burn the Witch content. You can just do what, hypothetically, what Seven Deadly Sins do, for example. If you want to talk about something that happened, you know, in the past, you just have to redraw it with the same studio so you don't conflict with copyrights, right? And that's kind of a hint to what I'm trying to say in a very roundabout way, is that, like, yeah, you can do a flashback in Burn the Witch of Bleach, but whoever's owning it or whoever's animating it would just have to animate it within their own style so it doesn't conflict with copyrights. I know I've just said it twice, but I have to hammer that nail in the coffin. So again, buying Bleach as well as Burn the Witch is a very important factor as to why I've been saying for absolutely for God knows how long that Bleach is in fact coming back. And now the evidence is coming to light, and it's beautiful and it's great, because now I can actually sit there and say, I told you so. I absolutely told you so. And again, things in the industry always change all the time, so things will get a bit confusing at times, but eventually it all pans out and it all makes sense. So, you know, it really be like that sometimes. So as far as the studio goes, do I know anything about the studio? Absolutely not. We can kind of conclude the studio, this is where it kind of gets speculatory, but it doesn't really matter because I believe it will be a good studio nonetheless, and I guess that can be the new topic of discussion, so to say. But what we do know is that, and this is an exclusive, I haven't said this on Twitter, is that Fuji TV have the broadcasting rights for Burn the Witch, which is very interesting because naturally, especially within some production committees, sometimes the TV studio or TV station, sorry, such as like TV Tokyo with Black Clover, they have the majority of the production. So like they're in essence the kind of production manager, like they're the big boys, like they, whatever they say goes, right? So like for TV Tokyo, if they want more Black Clover episodes, they're going to get more Black Clover episodes because they're the ones investing the most, right? But in this situation, Aniplex is the producer. They are the guys that are running the shots here, not Fuji TV. So we're not going to have Fuji TV, you know, calling the shots here. And, you know, it's not that bad of a thing. So whatever Fuji TV are used to working with, it's actually more so Aniplex, if that makes sense in a roundabout way. So what I mean by that is, well, who's a subsidiary? And what I mean by that, who's affiliated to Fuji TV and Aniplex? Well, we have people like David Productions and I guess Shaft in a way, yeah, because like they've kind of merged in a weird way as well. So we have A1 Pictures, we have Cloverworks, we have Ufotable, you know, we have maybe Madhouse, maybe, is Madhouse? No. So like you have to kind of look at what studios are affiliated with Fuji TV and with Aniplex. Now, I don't believe Toei will be working on this. As far as I know, I'm like 95% sure. Knowing my luck, it will be Toei Animation. It won't be. I think I've been told that it won't be. So we're good. We're good on that shit. So, you know, I'm not a big fan of A1, if I'm honest with you. Like, I just don't think they're cut out for the job. If it was up to me, I would say it will probably go to Cloverworks. I'm not a fan of their CG, if I'm completely honest, and I don't want them touching it, to be fair. But again, Ufotable is not the ones for Burn the Witch either. I think Bleach would be the ones for Ufotable. But again, we can have that discussion and we can talk about that, etc., etc. So I would like David Productions or Shaft to work on Burn the Witch. I think that would be a good studio, to be honest with you. So yes, there is, I'm not going to say, but there is going to be more than one OVA. That's going to be exciting. Because of the Olympics in spring 2020, there's not much anime broadcasting on TV. So these OVAs will have these weird theatrical releases that will then be, well, you'll see in the future, in essence. But that's not all. That's not all. Shonen Jump will also have a piece of this pie, to which I assume you guys are going to be... This is where it kind of gets controversial, but it's going to be exciting. For weekly content. Yes, for weekly content. So yes, weekly Shonen Jump will have a piece of that pie as well. And in the meanwhile, Aniplex will be doing what they can to garner the interest of Burn the Witch, see how well that does for them, and I assume... If it's a success, which I assume it will be, then Bleach will be in the making behind the scenes. Is it possible? Is it possible that they can announce a Bleach anime? Yes, it's completely possible. Absolutely. They can say, yeah, it's going to come, right? They could say that. They don't have to give us a day, but the idea that it's going to happen, it would be amazing, right? So, yes, they can announce it. Do I personally think that they will? I don't think that they will yet. But what else could they? They could say a movie. They really could. That's going to be interesting because I'm completely out the loop, to be honest, with that Bleach situation. But I know that, you know, Burn the Witch is going to be exciting. It's going to be a very exciting time. So yeah, I mean, that's as far as it kind of goes. More than one OVA, and then it's going to get rebroadcasted later on, probably by Fuji TV's whatever station that they've got going on. And then, meanwhile, there's going to be content being made of Burn the Witch while that's kicking off. And we're probably going to have this weird Dragon Ball Super situation. So that's going to be exciting. So again, it's very cool. Very, very big brain stuff. And again, this is why it's taken Bleach so long to come back. It's because realistically, the licenses have been insane with just... Basically, I think people have been selfish. I don't truly know the situation. I have an idea. But I guess with TV Tokyo kind of like on demand for like Boruto and Black Clover right now, like they haven't really got a decent time slot for Bleach right now. And again, like Peria, they're hanging on by a thread. They're really struggling. Like they're putting a lot of resource into Boruto and that's not exactly looking the best. It's pretty mediocre at best, to be honest, with like one or two really good episodes. But Black Clover's like struggling. I know that they're still struggling really bad. So Peria, they're a shell of their former self, I personally believe. And I'm kind of glad that Peria aren't touching Bleach again. So like, to be honest, I think as soon as they had like Tokyo Ghoul season 2, I think that's kind of where they fell off personally. But that's just me. That's just, again, like don't fucking hit me for that. So at the moment, it seems like, yes, TV Tokyo and Peria aren't on the production committee anymore. I don't know about Dentsu, to be honest with you. They were the advertising company. They probably won't, I don't believe. But in regards to people asking if Kudo or, you know, Sagasu for music will be coming back or Noriaki Ebe, I don't know because Ebe has worked for other studios in the past. Kudo has worked for other studios in the past. And the music for Bleach was owned by Aniplex and Sony anyway. So even though, so basically like Aniplex and Sony own that music, so they could bring it back. They really could like that. I don't see there being a problem. So like everything's possible. Like Kudo is possible because he's freelance. And Ebe to a certain extent isn't really contracted to a certain studio. So like these things are possible. But I would imagine that Aniplex will probably want them on board, but not as like the main staff, because I feel like they would want like a fresh approach to it, which is not a bad thing, to be honest with you. So I'm very excited to see where they're going to go with this. Again, the controversy is still there in regards to Bleach. I expected the controversy to be happening with Burn the Witch because people wanted a Bleach announcement, not a Burn the Witch announcement, but people are very excited for that. So that was one controversy that I wasn't actually worried about after it got out on the internet. So I'm very happy about that. But there is a big controversy with Bleach, and I think that controversy, realistically, I'm not going to say which one it is or isn't, but that controversy, for me, is going to be, is it going to be rebooted or not? That's another discussion I guess we can have in the future when I know more of what's kicking off. But I would say get excited. Talk about it a lot. Get Bleach trending. On the day of the event, it's going to be very exciting for all of us, and I think we should really approve of this decision move. Though I must say, it was also funny as well that, remember, there was a Bankai livestream, I believe this was in 2018, where the Byakuya voice actor, and I made a video about it, the Byakuya voice actor actually said, I look forward for more Bleach in the future. I made a video about it and tweeted about it, and some of the K-Lab staff told me that it was a mistranslation. Even though clearly now, it wasn't. That was funny, but hey, that's their job, and that's what they've got to do. I also have to say as well, this has nothing to do with Soccer Wars. That was just a nice little collaborative event, which is owned by Sega, and they're just doing their own thing. Obviously, we have the Soccer Wars anime coming out for that, and this has nothing to do with Soccer Wars. I have to really stress that out there as well. And it also might be the reason why you're seeing Crunchyroll literally, like, talk about Bleach a lot, too. Because, yeah, Crunchyroll knows what's up. As well as asking on Twitter if anyone had any questions. It's kind of the same kind of thing that I mentioned if the Bleach anime is going to be announced. I said it is possible, but I don't think so. I think it's too early. But then again, I have to question what else could there possibly be Bleach announcements in regards to that. I think it will be vaguely touched upon. But I'm very unsure about that. But I do believe that it is possible. It does really scratch my head. Again, why would the voice actors be there if they're not going to announce the anime, right? So, like, I have a very contradicting mindset on, like, what I believe in and what my head tells me. So it is an interesting one. But I'd be lying to you if I told you that I think it is, because I really just don't know. But again, two voice actors there from the Bleach anime. I mean, if I really wanted to be cynical about it, I could say the two male characters in Burn the Witch, that's who the voice actors are. But then again, Nakano is coming out too, which is the chief and editor, which, if you remember, guys, he said in the Bleach Year art book that, you know, please support Kubo and Bleach in the future. And I made a fucking video about that too. And everybody fucking ragtagged me for that too. I'm sorry. I have to do it because I've been waiting 7 years to fucking say I told you so. You should have listened to my videos, because everything I was saying was almost on fucking point. Like, most of the things were on point. There was a few things. I mean, I will say there was a few things where, like, I did tilt my head at. But the majority of things that I said were fucking correct. Naturally, someone said, what's my ideal animation studio? I think David Productions and Shaft would be really good for it. Euphotable for Bleach, but I think David Productions would be good for Burn the Witch. A1, again, I need to see the staff and director for it, because A1 can do it, but I don't have that much hope in them. And again, Cloverworks, again, is a good one too. I just don't like their CGI at all, because they did Fate Go pretty good, Fate Granddaughter, but their CGI is, ugh, Christ. Can it overtake the current anime like My Hero Academia, Dr. Stone, Fire Force, or will it be like Dragon Ball Super? Yes and yes. And how much I miss the fuck out of Bleach, man. This has been an emotional few weeks, to say the least. And I think I'll leave it off with this question too. The licensing and how it works, why do we have to wait for it to expire? Because you can't have two IPs running at the same time, right? Like, people, or like the consumers, would get very confused on, like, what products they're buying, right? So, like, you can't, and this is a big hint as well, okay? You get this big hint. You can't have a 1,000-year Blood War anime, right, and then expect the audience to buy the past Bleach anime for a company that doesn't own it anymore and isn't distributing it anymore. So that would be weird, right? Like, that would just be a weird, yeah, you have to wait for it to expire, unfortunately, because again, there's a lot of lawsuits that can happen and X, Y, and Z. It's a weird mess. So that's like the easiest way I can explain it without really fucking up anything or explaining anything really badly. But yeah, what do I expect from this day forward? I expect you guys are going to hear about the Burn the Witch anime. Hopefully they explain everything to you. Hopefully we get some production committee information soon to validate things that I've said. And we can understand the thought process of what's going to happen. And we can talk about, we can just talk about what happens at this point. But for Bleach, I think Bleach will be extremely very minimal, if I'm honest with you. It's coming back, everyone. And I hope we all enjoy ourselves so we can watch some amazing content, talk about some amazing content, and create some amazing content. But with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, Hanson. And before I sign you guys out, go watch my Burn the Witch video, because I need to get my channel retention up because of the recent hacking, which I may talk about later on. But please go watch that video. Please bump that up as much as you can. Also, please go check out my social medias. That'd be great as well. And of course, if you want to go check out the Patreon, or if you want to donate, please click in the description down below and help me out. With that being said, though, peace out.